inert light and fundamental components that has the power to make the mood of any piece. Light has the ability to modify an artwork, whether it be traditional or digital, giving it many moods and feelings that can capture the attention of the viewer. Since lighting enables me to bring my artwork to life and invite people to go deeper into it, as an artist, I always pay attention to lighting. Albert Bestard is one artist who has expertly illustrated the importance of light in art. Although Bestard's landscape are recognized for their extraordinary grandeur and beauty, it's his use of light to impart depth and dimensionality that truly distinguishes his work. His works use a variety of light and effects, such as dramatic shadows cast by a stormy sky to the delicate glow of the sun on a mountain peak. It's evidence of how light can change a piece of art and carry the viewer to another dimension. Artists may produce spectacular lighting effects using plenty of tools and methods in the digital world. I can experiment with various lighting configurations using Blender, including adding different light sources, changing the color and intensity of the lighting, and producing elaborate atmospheric effects like fog and haze. There are a few methods that I prefer to use when making a lighting in a Blender. Volumetric lights includes development of volumetric material that interacts with the light source to provide a wonderful atmospheric effect. Using HDRI is a different strategy that may be utilized to provide realistic lighting and reflection in the environment, and using combination of different approaches. In this Blender lighting tutorial, I will share my approach to working with light in a Blender. Well, in a Blender, one of the easiest way to create atmospheric light is by using the standard sky texture. With just a few clicks, I can turn on the standard HDRI sky and instantly create a beautiful and immersive environment for my concept art. Here I can use settings like sun intensity, rotation, and I have completely control over the look and feel of the lighting. If I want to create a specific time of day, such as stunning sunset or bright midday scene, I can simply move the sun down to the horizon and adjust the air, dust and ozone settings to achieve the perfect atmospheric impact. And even if your PC isn't the most powerful, this approach is fast and efficient, allows you to focus on your creative process and bring your ideas to life. The second way that I love to use to create stunning light in Blender is by using the physical starlight and atmosphere add-on in the Blender to create atmospheric light. With just a few clicks, I can turn on the physical atmosphere and instantly create a beautiful and immersive environment for my artwork. The add-on even includes the ability to create procedural clouds and stars, adding an extra layer of depth to my creations. In fact, I recently used the physical starlight and atmospheric add-on in one of my artworks and was blown away by the result. One of the major advantages of using this add-on is the object fog effect, which automatically creates a beautiful and realistic fog that adds to the overall atmosphere of the artwork. By using this approach, I am able to create atmospheric landscape and lighting that truly captures the essence of my artistic vision. And it's incredible fast and efficient, allowing me to focus on my creative process and bring my ideas to life. Find the link to my Blender video in the description where I used physical starlight and atmosphere and see how it's really fast and amazing to create an atmosphere. So, this vase allows me to create atmospheric landscape and atmospheric light. But I have my favorite method to create light in a blender. This approach consists of combination of images of the sky and the standard blender sun. In this way, I have an opportunity to control the skylight, sun and global light separate. This is important when you cannot achieve the desired result using physical correct light. Yeah, quite often physics doesn't allow us to create a desired result and we need to find some other way. For example, I want the sun will be between these mountains and shine on the ship and touch these rocks somewhere here to separate my foreground and background. But as you see, when I'm using blender light, I can't achieve this because the sun shines in this direction and I have to move objects that allow the light will pass between rocks and the highlight object as I want, or I should rotate HDRI and lose the sun position. Anywhere, all these ways will ruin my composition and light. That's why for the concept art and creative works where the creative result is more important, I use several types of lighting. For this I take image for the sky, put it as a base color and emission for the material just for the skylight with the right position of the sun and a nice reflection on the wall. For the global light I will use standard blender global light and for the main light I will take the blender sun. This combination allows me to control three types of lighting separately. I can colorize the scene with global light and just choose some color in the settings. I can control how the sky impact on my art. Also, it helps me to highlight those objects which I want to emphasize. This way allows me to be flexible in my art and achieve the same results that I visualized in my mind. But using this approach, you must remember that everything should happen in one lot of light. I mean, if your sun here, your scene must lighten from this point. You may move a little bit of sun just for the illustration, but everything must be in the same direction. Creating this would be incorrect and look strange. When you use a combination of light, important to create everything from the one side. Light is a crucial element that has profound impact on my artwork, whether digital or traditional. It's particularly evident in classic art, where the artist must create the desired atmosphere with their own skills and imagination. The way an artist uses light can greatly enhance, detract from the overall feeling and mood of the piece. In digital art using Blender, you have even more control over lighting and can experiment with various techniques to achieve the desired effect. By manipulating light, you can create stunning sunsets, gloomy and dark scenes, or anything in between. The possibilities are endless and the ability to control lighting is a significant advantage of digital art. I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it helpful. If you wanna support my channel, please consider subscribe and press the like button below. That helps YouTube will show this video to more people. Drop your comment in the section below. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.